Bruce Pearl has certainly had some success since leaving the Vols. He had success in Knoxville, success in Auburn, and he has owned the series, but gives a lot of praise, Austin, to this Vols team and what should be a great game tomorrow, especially because Tennessee's at home and we know how they play at Thompson Bowling Arena.
No, you're exactly right, Jonathan. Bruce Pearl's very savvy. He's a veteran. He knows how to, talk up the opponent, especially one that, he does have a lot of respect for, and a place he has a lot of respect for. So I'm not surprised at all to hear him come out with the comments that he had high praise for this Tennessee team. But it also was to kind of fire up his team and kind of get them motivated for what will be a raucous, hostile atmosphere at Thompson Bowling Arena tomorrow. And this is an Auburn team that's lost, a couple of games in conference, both on the road, both very close. They're still unbelievably talented. But I think he wants to kind of whip them into shape and, kind of get them focused on what is a big game for the Tigers just as much as it is for Tennessee.
Are there campouts? The students camping out for this game?
I don't know if they are or not. I would say no, but it's not till 4 o'clock tomorrow, so you can.
If you're looking for a reason to do something different on campus, Chad would be camping out.
They'll get there early. I've never camped out, but I guarantee you there will be a line there early tomorrow morning that'll wait all day to get in early. There's no doubt about that. To me, Austin, just a huge part of this game. John Fulkerson can't have two shots or 2 points in this game. I know he's coming off the hip injury, but Fulkerson with the emergence of Adu. Is Brandon Huntley Hatfield turning a corner for this team? I think Plofsich is what he is at this point, but what do you think about Tennessee's post players holding up against Jabari Smith and Walker Kessler, which is a very different type of challenge?
It is. It's more so the old Sports Center, slogan. You don't expect to stop them. You just can hope to contain them. I think that's the thing. Can Tennessee do enough? Kessler's going to have blocks. He's going to, get some easy points in the paint. Jabari Smith's phenomenally talented. But can you just slow him down enough, And maybe it's one of those situations where it's, hey, let's let those two have theirs and not let anybody else have anything. You can go a couple of different ways here. Because, Auburn's guards aren't nearly as talented as they have been in years past, especially when Bruce made that Final Four run a few years ago. But they're still very capable. And so the last thing you want to do is kind of fall asleep, on those guards trying to, focus on Kessler and Jabari. So, I think more than anything, it's kind of, just kind of do what you do, play solid defense, and see what happens inside TBA. When you look at the best teams in the conference, guys, Kentucky hasn't lost at home. I don't think Arkansas has lost at home. Tennessee has not lost at home, and neither has Auburn. Those are the four best teams in the conference, and they're all good at home for what reason? Because they're all tough places to play, and it's hard to win on the road against a quality opponent. So, this is a real chance for Tennessee to get a huge quad one win and, potentially finish this thing out 4-0 down the stretch here after that loss to Arkansas.